race recap for week four at Bowman Gray. Once again, not a bad week for us. We had a fast race car, not quite fast enough. We qualified third, finished third in the first race. You know, that's the race where we start straight up for qualifying the 25 lappers. Qualified third. I thought we ran a good lap. It was we ran a 13.30, and that's the fastest lap I've ever run around Bowman Gray. And 3.2 was my fastest, but it wasn't quite good enough. Tim and Burke both beat us qualifying, so we, like I said, we ended up third, finished third in the first race. Tim pulled a 16 to invert for the second race, which put us starting 14th, which is not, I mean, you're never in a good spot starting 14th, even if it is a 25 lapper. I thought we were going to be okay. We actually missed the big wreck. They had a big wreck on the first lap when we finally got going. We actually got stopped for the wreck, but they ended up putting us in the rear anyway because I guess they considered us involved in the wreck because we stopped. But, you know, that's the scoring over there. That's how it goes. It seems like that's about the third time this year we've kind of got the raw end on the scoring. But, I don't know, you take the good with the bad. It is Bowman Gray. You know what you're getting into when you go over there. So, you know, it's not a surprise when you get screwed on the lineup. But we made it through the wreck. We didn't tear anything up. We had a little body damage, but, you know, nothing major. We ended up 10th. So, you know, not a bad week. I kind of wish Tim would have pulled a little better number for that second race, and we might could have got another top five. I think we've been in the top five finish every week, every race, except for that second 25 lap or so. We didn't win, which is not good, but not bad either. Finishing decent, so we're getting better, getting a little better every week, so hopefully here before too long. Maybe this week coming up double points will be the week we pull out a win. That's when we probably need it the most, so we'll see. Go ahead and give them all we got. All right, we're going to take a little time in our video this week to kind of plug our sponsors a little bit. You know, they're a huge part of what we do. Without them, it's really tough to try to run one of these things out of your pocket. Our newest one is Auto Sports of Kernersville. Really super, super nice car dealership. Ronnie and Jeff and those guys over there, they've come on board with us this year to try to help us out. And, you know, like I said, we're going to try to help them out and see if we can't sell a few cars for them. At least get them some customers over there looking around. they're our newest one, and we're glad to have them with us. All right, we got a few more here on the side of the car. The Trantham Moorfield Enterprises, Mark Moorfield, Roy Trantham. They help us keep motors in these cars. They're a big part of this race team. Wendell Edwards. Wendell takes care of us. He's been with us for 5 or 6, 7 years now. You can't ask for a better guy than Wendell. He's a good family friend. He takes care of us. Racing Electronics, they keep our radios on top. You know, we never have any radio problems, knock on wood. They really look after us. Brown & Miller Racing Solutions, they make oil lines for the race cars. And they really take care of us when we need some oil lines. They about got the best product you can buy, and that works out good for both of us. We get the best parts on our car, and they put their parts on good cars. So. Andy Fitzgerald, the lawyer's office in Winston-Salem, they help take care of Winston, and JR's Country Palace. Those guys have been with us for a couple years now. You know, real good friendships with those people, and you know, they help us get to the track every week. We picked up Miraculous Auto Wash and Detailing this year. You know, guy, you know, lives here close, good friend. He takes care of washing our trailers and our cars and stuff like that, and trying to help us keep us looking good. You know, even when you have a bad night, you still want to look good, you know. So, it gave a lot of motive engines. You know, we got away from what we were running last year, and George Gable, he takes care of us. And, you know, I don't think we're hurting on motor at all. I think we got some of the best motor on the racetrack. So, you know, that really helps. Now, Winning Edge Fabrication, he came along and helped us a little bit this year. You know, every little bit helps with these cars. You know, it's tough getting them to the racetrack every week, just the manpower and the time it takes, but then the money on top of that, it's really tough. And those guys help us do what we do. So we just want to thank them and help support them and support us. You know, if you need something, you know, you can get in touch with any of these people. They got phone numbers and websites and all that good stuff.